Hey, how are you?
Fine, yourself?
Who are we talking to today on this episode of 15 with Ed Johnson?
You're speaking to Conrad Landay.
Okay. Conrad, when and where were you born?
I was born in New York City. Well, actually, I was born in the Bronx in 1971.
Where did you grow up?
I grew up in the Bronx,
specifically.
Actually. Specifically, kind of did a little bouncing around. Cortona Park in the South Bronx, over here where we are currently at Valentine Avenue off the Grand Concourse. did a bit over on over in Pelham Parkway, and now as my adult life, I'm back here.
What was it like growing up then?
Actually, it was a lot of fun. It was, I guess, probably some of the best memories of my childhood stem from this neighborhood and from this hallway in that apartment.
In that apartment there. Mm-hmm. Who were your parents?
Conrad Rafael Landay and Margarita Jimenez.
And how was your relationship with them?
As good as any child-parent relationship, I guess. Pretty cool with my mom, pretty cool with my dad.
Do you remember what it was like what was going through your head when you first saw or first learned that you were going to be a parent to yourself?
Well, my daughter was completely planned. So when I saw the pregnancy test at like 5:30 in the morning, elated, absolutely elated, very happy with the fact that I was going to be a parent. Didn't care what the child was going to be, whether or not it was a boy or a girl, just wanted it healthy. 10 fingers and 10 toes, but absolutely elated.
How did you choose her name?
Well, my ex-wife, I am a divorcee, my ex-wife, we were going back and forth on names. I didn't really agree with any of the choices she was making, she didn't agree with any of the choices I was making, and one day out of the blue she came up to me and said, well, why don't we name her Samara, because she really liked the name Olivia. And I was like, I conceded on that. I was like, all right, fine, we could use Olivia, but I don't want it to be her first name. So she came up to me one day and said, well, we'll name her Samara Olivia Landay. And I was like, oh my God, that's amazing. Her initials spell S-O-L, which is sol, sun in Spanish, not meaning that she would be a boy, but, you know, the sun itself, you know, a brightness in my life. And then she said, well, do you know where I got that name from? I was like, I had no clue. And she turns around and says, well, remember the ring? I was like, yeah, who in the ring was named Samara? I was like, well, the little girl that came out the well, the little creepy girl. I was like, you're kidding me, her? That's brilliant. Now we have a great story to tell. And yeah, that's where the name came from. And once my ex told me, I was like, yeah, that's her name.
Do you have a love of your life?
My daughter. That is the love of my life. She is the most important person in my life, that child. And she is the coolest person I know, the funniest little individual I know, and yeah, that's the love of my life right there.
Did you ever think of that you would get divorced when you got married?
No, actually I didn't. I never thought that a lot of things happened, but they did happen. It's not something that I'm necessarily proud of, but it happened.
What do you do for a living?
I am an illustrator graphic designer for a costume company.
Tell me about a day in the life of at work for you.
Actually, work is great. And hadn't been employed for a while. A friend of mine was able to get me this job. Basically, get in at 9:30, anywhere, you know, between 9:15 and 9:30, sit down, eat my breakfast, and then just start drawing. Or designing things. I do anything from packaging to costume concepts. Either a product developer or an actual clothing designer will come up to me and say, this is the idea that I have. Excuse me, please elaborate on it. You know, work your magic. So go ahead and I do that and we present it. It either gets approved and moves forward or not. So pretty much the day is spent in front of the computer drawing or just designing things. And I work with a really good bunch of people and a lot of it is like, you know, quiet because I listen to my headphones, but also jokey. We have a good crew of people. So it's a lot of fun.
Is this what you thought you'd do when you grew up?
Hell no.
What'd you think that you would do when you grew up?
I was hoping I was going to be a comic book artist. That's what I thought I was going to be. But, you know, life kind of gets in the way. To be a comic book artist, you kind of have to dedicate a big chunk of time just to drawing. And just things got in the way of that.
So is that dream completely dead now?
No, I don't think it's completely dead. I think it's still very possible to do it. It's just, we'll take a little longer to get something accomplished. I should have been able to do it when I was much younger, when I did have the time. But now that I've got more experience and better ability, and also the technology, I don't see where that would not be possible.
So if you could do anything right now, what would you do and why?
Anything? I guess my ideal work situation, is that what you mean?
Yeah.
I guess ideal work situation would be probably illustrating from home. You know, having a decent computer system worked up and a drafting table and just do illustrations from home. That would probably be my ideal work situation.
I'm going to ask you the question that I pretty much ask everyone at the end of these things. I think you know what that is. What is your favorite sexual position?
Missionary. No. Sorry. I had to do that as a joke. My favorite sexual position is actually cowgirl. I like the woman on top. I like to be able to... I think that unlike missionary, cowgirl, and unlike doggy, cowgirl, you get to see the woman completely. You know? And you're... She's much more involved with it, as are you. You know, you're able to appreciate the woman's form. You're able to touch her body a little more easily than if you were on top. And also just help manipulate in certain movements and stuff. I think cowgirl for me is the best position, the one I enjoy the most.
All right. Well, Conrad, that was your 15.
Hi, I'm Conrad, and this was my 15.
Thanks, Conrad.